Hello and welcome to Daily Red Video. In this video, I like to give my honest review of CleanMyMac 10. It is actually 10, it is not X. It is the anniversary version of CleanMyMac software, which is released by MacPa recently. And similar to iPhone 10, you know, you need to pronounce it as CleanMyMac 10. It is the anniversary version. So let's get back to the topic. So in this review, I like to give my honest opinion about what this software can actually do and who actually needs it. The first point I like to cover is who actually needs it. And the second one is what are the new features that you can find compared to the CleanMyMac 3. And finally, some overview of the features and conclusion whether you will be needing this application or not. So to answer that first query, my first point is whether you need it or not. If you are using a latest Mac computer, like if you have purchased your Mac computer within last 2 years with SSD powered Mac computers, then you definitely don't need this. Your Mac should be running fine. Unless if you are watching this review because your Mac is getting slow due to the third-party applications that you are using, then you may consider trying this application for 30 days. I'll leave the link of the trial version in the description of this video. Give this a try and see how much performance difference you are noticing before and after using this application. And if you're convinced, then you can go ahead and purchase it. But my recommendation would be, to be honest, you don't need this if your Mac is already running fine. And you can bookmark this video, you know, you can save this video for future use, because after using lots and lots of user third-party applications, you may be needing this software. The reason I'm telling you is it is not possible, you know, to entirely depend on the Apple ecosystem within the App Store, Mac App Store applications. Even though you use you limit yourself within the Apple Mac App Store ecosystem, it is possible that the apps that you use will store plenty and plenty of data with your knowledge and without your knowledge into your hard disk drive or SSD. So that is the problem, where it clogs the computer sometimes, where the applications delays the indexing process when you search for some files, and when it hangs or crashes, you know, all these things happen because the memory of your computer becomes clogged. And it's your, not just your RAM memory, also your hard disk drive. You can free up your storage because storage is very, very important when you purchase Apple Mac products. For every single gigabytes of data, you're paying several dollars according to Apple. So it is precious. The data storage amount is precious. So you need to manage it efficiently. And there were, you know, a few utilities I came across and I wasn't satisfied. You know, I had to do a lot of manual work and I was not able to trust them. So that's why I thought to go for some premium application. And I'm really happy with CleanMyMac. So to, you know, complete the first point that I'm trying to say, if you are using the new Mac computer, 95% you don't consider to buy this app. If the Mac is getting slow frequently due to the third-party applications, then you may consider purchasing it. And the next point is about the features. Like compared to the CleanMyMac 3, I see just two new feature additions. The UI is pretty beautiful. It is, you know, it is gorgeous. There is no doubt about it. It is so Apple-like design. I really love this design. And the first one is the malware removal, and the second one is optimization, which related to the speed category. So the optimization, you know, first let me explain the optimization, which is a new feature. You know, according to me, I find this new because I haven't found this in CleanMyMac 3. So this application will let you to take control of all the applications that is in your login items, or, you know, it does more than what the activity monitor in your Mac computer does. So it will help you to take control of all the third-party applications that you have installed and consuming, you know, process heavily in your computer, whether it is RAM process or CPU usage. And if you are seeing any hung applications, any applications got hanged, then you will be seeing that in this category. So it is well organized and it will help you to, you know, perform the task where you can clean it, you can terminate it. You can easily, you know, manage all your system core functionalities here. So this is one interesting feature, you know, I would say, that makes the CleanMyMac even more powerful than it was before with the version 3. And the next one is malware removal. I personally feel that this might still be in beta version. So reason is, like, it is not real-time protection. It gets updated from the MacPa's database maybe. So they might be having a separate team to update the signature, virus signature signature database here. So if there are any Mac malwares identified when you are browsing the web, when you are transferring applications from the web or from your friends, if there are any malicious files spotted that may be related to the adware, spyware, or malware, or any ransomware even, you know, they are promising that they will be able to protect your Mac from all those things. I personally feel that this is a good feature and it requires more developments, which I believe the team will do in upcoming versions, in upcoming updates that the users will get. And you know, it is a good start. That's what I feel. It is a good start to protect the Mac, you know, to provide a basic level of malware protection. And in the era of ransomware, you know, it is essential to have this sort of built-in functionality, you know, apart from the Apple you know, the default security measures. It'll be great to have a proper, a trusted antivirus software with the Mac to protect your computer from, you know, all sorts of latest threats and attacks. I find this, you know, feature as pretty attractive and requires a lot of improvement. So that's my conclusion. And finally, the third point, it has all the bells and whistles that you can find it on the Mac, the CleanMyMac 3, version 3. So you can clean up your iTunes junk files. You know, every time you listen to music, you download songs from iTunes, Apple Music. They store, you know, a lot of temporary data. The broken downloads are being stored as a temporary data in your system. So all these, you will be amazed, you know, when you perform the scan, you will be amazed how much data you can actually free up from your hard disk drive. I'm using the macOS Mojave, so it requests for permission whenever you try to run an application. I really love this UI, the all new UI, which looks pretty great. And here you can see I'm able to clear 18.2 gigabytes of data from my 512 gigabytes of SSD. And this is wonderful. You know, every time you perform a cleaning, like not immediately, but every week or twice a week, I would recommend you to perform the cleaning task, and it'll free up, you know, several gigabytes of data based on your usage. If you're using a lot of Adobe applications, image editing, video editing, and you know, if you take a lot of backups of your photo from your iOS devices, then this app will do really wonderful with digging all the files that are you know, stored and never been touched or used by you. This smart scan is just, you know, an overview sort of cleanup. If you want to dive deeper, then you can use all these specific cleaning functions, you know, features to clean up all your system, you know, by letting the CleanMyMac dive deeper and find the files that you were not using. So overall, as a conclusion, I would say this is an amazing application. And again, I'm sticking to my point. If you have bought the Mac computer recently, you don't need this. And only, you know, download and or purchase it if you're finding, you know, a lot of hangs and system slow speed issues. Otherwise, for older Mac computers, which has a traditional hard disk drive and SSD drive, and still it is getting hanged, then definitely I would recommend this software. I did give my, you know, detailed review in a blog post, in deleted blog post. I will include that link in the description of this video. Do check that out. If you have any doubts related, any questions related to this application, feel free to comment below. I will be happy to answering all your questions. Also, don't forget that you can always give it a trial version a try before, you know, purchasing this software for $39.99, and there are discounts, of course. So if you are an existing customer of MacPie, you can always get a 30% extra off. If you have already purchased CleanMyMac 3 or CleanMyMac 2, then you can upgrade to the latest version, CleanMyMac 10, with 50% offer. So I'll include all these, you know, details in the description of this video. You can click and go there to avail that offer. I believe this review was helpful to you. Feel free to ask me any questions if you have. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day.